Hello viewers, I am Rakib. In this lesson, I will show you how you can crop an image, resize it, and transform an image. So let's get started with cropping. You can click the crop tool, select it. Also, you can press C from your keyboard. And as soon as you click on the crop tool, you can see a box defining the edge of the cropping. You can redefine it just dragging it like this. Let's set it there and change the height to like this. And then you can press enter from your keyboard. That's our cropped image. Now we can save it as file save. This is the name of the file, and we need to change it because if we put the same name, then it will replace our original image. So we will put something here and click save. And now, as I said before, I will always set the quality value to 8, and make sure you have checked this preview so that you get an estimation of the file size. Then you can click OK and you can see the cropped image. There are some other options of cropping. Let's select some other options for cropping. If we select the square, then we will get a square image. We can reposition it, and we can also set it to original ratio. Then we can drag this point. That will maintain the ratio of the original image, and we can move our image inside of the box, and then we can crop it like this. And there is one more option I will show you, which is this one. It allows us to put the value of the width, height, and the resolution. So let's consider we want an image that has 400 pixel wide, 400 pixel height, and resolution is 300. So put this value to 400 pixel. 400 pixel. And you can put some other units if you want, but I will put it as pixel, and the resolution is 300 because this is the resolution of the original image. And then we can crop it like this. So if we go to image size, then you can see we have an image that has width and height, with both are 400. So another thing you can do with the crop tool is, if you double click this layer, make it a regular layer, and then you select the crop tool and drag this. Just clear this presets. You can clear this by clicking the clear. Now we can move it as we want, just like this. We are just increasing the canvas. So now we have a bigger canvas than earlier. Let's position this, and in this way you can increase the canvas of an image and do some other editing or designing with it. And there's another way of resizing an image. You can go to image size. Then if you put this value to 300, then the height will be automatically set to 300 because it's maintaining the original ratio of the image. If you click here, then it will be unchecked, and then if you change this value, then it will not maintain the ratio it was maintaining before. So always make sure this one is checked, and then you put your desired value in this box. So if you want an image having a width of 200, then put that value. It will change its height proportionately, and then you can press OK. In that way, you can also resize an image. So now one more thing, that's the image transformation. Let's increase the canvas of this image like this, and if we this image is selected in this layer, and if we press Ctrl T from our keyboard, that shows a box. This is the transformation box. If we want it to be smaller, we can just press and hold the shift key from our keyboard and drag this point. In that way, it's reducing the dimension of this image without changing its quality. You can press enter and it's done. You can also increase or decrease its size by this transform box, and also you can rotate an image using this transformation. If you press and hold the shift key, it will be set at certain degree angle like this, and just go back to the previous. Okay, so there are some other features of this transformation, and if we create another copy of this same layer, then press Ctrl T from your keyboard, and if we go edit, transform, and then flip horizontal, then this image is the flip version of this image. So if we press the V, then apply the transformation. Yes, apply. So now we get a transformed image from this one. It's horizontally flipped, and now select this both image, drag it, and if we press Ctrl T, then we are getting a box for the transformation of this both layers. And if we go to edit, transform, and flip vertical, that will flip the both images vertically. And now you can see how you can create the variation of your image using this transformation. Sometimes it's very essential when you see something in the left and you need exactly the same thing, but the mirrored view on right side, then you can create it just copying the same thing from the left and just flipping it horizontally to create the right side of certain things. So that's it for this tutorial. Hope to see you guys the next time. Thank you.